I'm Maggie Wilder, and welcome to In the Moment, boom, 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 boom. The National Conservatory of Dramatic Arts series designed to give you tools
for your actor's toolbox
and help you take your performances to the next level. Today, we're going to be talking about size and intensity. Get your minds out of the gutter. You may have heard someone say that an actor's performance was too big. In fact, people often say this about stage actors as they're making the transition to film performance. Stage performances require
a larger presence.
As long as I don't get confused. But I do get confused easily. But I don't get confused that easily. Yes, I do. I'm my own worst enemy. Stop being negative. I'm not being negative. I'm being realistic. I'll screw it up. I always do. Who screws it up? You. You're the role model for village idiots everywhere. Me? You're nothing without me. You're the cock-up. Don't you call me a cock-up, you cock-up.
And it can be difficult to rein it in. There are just some moments where a small performance is better.
In case I don't see you. Good afternoon, good evening, and good night.
And there can be moments where a big performance is better.
Hold on, sugar! Daddy's got a sweet tooth tonight!
And while a performance like Jim Carrey's In the Mask is appropriate for some films,
somebody stop me!
It's not appropriate for others.
I'm talking about the boy's nature now. Not anything he's done. You can't hold a child responsible for what God gave him to be.
Somebody stop me!
Somebody stop it. When we hear an actor's performance is too big, the problem is usually that they misuse two of the tools in their actor's toolbox. Intensity and size.
But what's the difference?
You see, size is related to volume, the actual decibel level of your voice, and physical gesture, how much space you take up with your body. Let's take a look at a couple examples of size. In Dolomite Is My Name, Eddie Murphy and Wesley Snipes use size to demonstrate both the enthusiasm and the amateurism of the people they're playing.
Yeah, come on, Willie Green. No, Willie Green. Damn it, cheap ass gun.
God damn, Dolomite.
In this clip from American Psycho, we see Christian Bale as Patrick Bateman use size in order to display his insanity.
It was a little too new wave for my taste. But when sports came out in 83, I think they really came into their own, commercially and artistically.
Observe all the traits that, were he doing a sane character, we would describe as bad acting traits. The false voice, the massive facial movement, the indication with his body. But by using size to his advantage, he gives us a truly creepy character.
He's been compared to Elvis Costello, but I think Huey has a far more bitter, cynical sense of humor.
Hey, Albert Stram.
Yes, Alan?
Why are there copies of the style section all over the place? Do you have a dog? A little chow or something?
No, Helen.
Is that a raincoat?
Yes, it is. In 87, Huey released this, Four, their most accomplished album. I think their undisputed masterpiece is Hip to Be Square. A song so catchy, most people probably don't listen to the lyrics, but they should, because it's not just about the pleasures of conformity and the importance of trends. It's also a personal statement about the band itself. Hey, Paul!
That was size. But intensity is related to your emotional power. How important something is in a scene. Farid. instance, in this scene from Birdman, Michael Keaton's character Regan Thompson is approaching the famous New York theater critic Tabitha Dickinson, played by Lindsay Duncan. His entire career depends on what she says about his play on opening night.
I'm going to destroy your play.
But you didn't see it. You know, did I do something to offend you?
As a matter of fact, you did. You took up space in a theater which otherwise might have been used on something worthwhile.
Okay, well, I mean, you don't even know if it's any good or not. I didn't...
That's true. I haven't read a word of it or even seen a preview. But after the opening tomorrow, I'm going to turn in the worst review anybody has ever read. And I'm going to close your play. Would you like to know why? Because I hate you and everyone you represent. Entitled, selfish, spoiled children. Blissfully untrained, unversed, and unprepared to even attempt real art. Handing each other awards for cartoons and pornography. Measuring your worth in weekends.
A lot of actors think that because something's important, it needs size. But that's not necessarily true. Usually the most important moments in our lives require intensity, but they may or may not require size. Let's take a look at this moment from The Crucible. This entire scene is incredibly important, and all the characters are acting with true intensity, but there's only one moment where we see size.
You're the High Court, your word is good enough. Tell them Proctor broke to his knees and wept like a woman. But my name I cannot sign.
Why? Do you mean to deny this confession when you are free?
I mean to deny nothing.
Then explain to me why you will
because
not...
Because it is my name! Because I cannot have another in my life! Because I lie and sign myself to lies! Because I am not worth the dust on the feet of them you have hanged. I have given you my soul. Leave me my name!
Is that document a lie? If it is, I will not accept it.
So next time you're in a scene that requires your emotional investment, play with the ideas of intensity and size until you find what's true. Ba-dum-boom-boom. In the moment. Until next time, I'm Maggie Wilder.
In case I don't see ya.
Good afternoon, good evening, and good night.